All right. Got this throw-in 5-horse antique Briggs engine. We're going to find out, will it run?
Yeah, pull out that plug. See what that bad boy looks like. Ooh, very loose. Very loose. No tool required.
Well, don't look too bad.
See, can we see anything moving in there? We see a valve opening. That's good. Oh, I see valves moving. All right, so this got some movement in it. We don't have frozen. We got motion. This plug has seen better days, though. Nice and secure. Clean the terminal. Good, tight. Got the boot on there, good. So we got movement. We don't have a frozen engine. We could have some real antique gasoline in there, which is as good as crud right now. Probably gonna need to take off the carburetor and give it a good cleaning. I don't know how old the fuel in this thing is. So it probably is worthwhile to start dismantling this thing and seeing if we can't clean it apart, clean it up. And this thing is just a messy, sooty, cruddy mess. I may just soak this thing in WD before I take this thing apart. Look at this thing. What a disaster. Cruddy. But it moves. It surely moves. So it's got a chance. It's got a chance at life again. Hold on. Finish what I'm doing here. Are you playing with Nathan?
No, he left.
He left? Where'd he go?
He left.
Oh.
He just said he had to leave because it kept saying unable to connect.
All right, let me get this back on the bench and then I'll come in and play. No numbers anywhere. Usually you see a Briggs number stamp somewhere on here. Oh, there we go. Looks like this is a 1986 engine. 86-07-1806. I'm going to have to look up what all those numbers mean, but I remember that the first two digits correspond to the year of manufacture. So that makes me think that this engine's almost as old as I am. Three Phillips head screws up here seem to be holding the carburetor, holding the fuel tank on the carburetor. All right, we need to be careful with that one. Okay, got her. Thought we might have to soak that one. So we got another 7/16 bolt right under here. Oh, that's wrong. It's not 7/16. A little smaller. Be 3/8. Scoop this a little over to the edge of the table here. So I can put a wrench on it and maybe catch it before it come down. This bottom is out. Right? You're out. So I think I got now what looks like a mess of old fuel. It's just like total crud. I had a gasket here, I think, that's missing a little bit over here. But I got what looks like a return. I got a lot of cruddy looking fuel that I'm going to want to dump. Funnel in a container for this. This stuff is rather stinky. Fuel tank smells awful, 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 like old varnish. I'm gonna replace those gaskets. I'm gonna see if I can remove this one as delicately, not so delicately.
to scrape that off.
And some of these pieces are falling in there, but I'm not going to worry about it. I'm going to clean that out. Thank you.
right, so I just cheated a little bit. Took this thing over to the wire wheel on the grinder. Probably should have done that a little sooner. Took the paint off a little more than I wanted to. However, this gasket surface is now nice and clean. The money part, I think, for today's work is going to be cleaning out the muck that is inside of this tank. Because there is a lot of crud in there. Let's see if I can get a light. Make it visible. There we go. Oh, crud. Crud. Doesn't seem like a problem with rust as much as it's a problem with just old crusty fuel turning to varnish. You can just see it's brown. It smells quite bad. Filled with dark, crusty sediment that would not make an engine happy. So here's how we're gonna fix it. We got some cooking rice, and we're gonna put some rice in this fuel tank. Fuel in these return areas too, some rice in here. Close up this tank and hold my hands over return here. Move over the tools a little bit, and then I'm going to give it a good, healthy shaking. Reach my finger in here and smash those grains around a little bit. Hopefully that working like a
little power washers pulverizing the inside of this thing, drying out that crusty old fuel. How it's going. Right, so we got a lot of rice stuck around in there. And this thing really still smells, but it does seem to have, does seem to be helping. Might even just let this stuff sit in here for a little while.
Some rice here, you know what? Let's try some fresh rice here. That to me is looking like an improvement. There's definitely still some crud in there. But I think it's working.
All right, we're gonna take this muffler off so we can get to that carburetor. A couple of 7/16 bolts. Muffler, and now we can get to our carb. Now we got a few connections to the carb. They're gonna need to come out. One of them is this vacuum line here. See, the way this thing's got to move, we're going to have to hook up and hook some of the mechanicals here to get to the mounting bolt and get that carb off. Get a little wrench to get two bolts. Keeping that carb on. Thank you. cylinder. Did somebody cut these bolts this way? Or is this how they came? Check that out. Here's to be a machined bolt. And the crosshatch in it. Oh, interesting. Alright, so I got the carb on, got a choke, got some linkages that seem to be working all right. I know we got a needle valve in there. Got some pickups that don't look too bad. And behind here we've got a diaphragm that I've seen spoil. And some younger machines, so let's take a look back here and see what it looks like. Thank you. Oof. Wow. Spring in a cup. Ugh, it's a more real foul smelling fuel. Just trapped in there. Ugh. That doesn't look in bad shape at all. Maybe it is. Maybe it's got a little ring on it. All right, I got the front of this thing off. I soaked these bolts. There's 8 bolts at the top holding the head on. I'm gonna take those things off now. Probably halves. Voila. Well now, that don't look too bad. Does not look too bad. I'll get you a look at the underside. Cylinder head. Whoop. Without losing any of your bolts here. I think we can clean that up and she'll be just fine. And now look at that, turning that thing around. That cylinder's in pretty dadgum good shape. We got valves that open. I'd say that cylinder looks quite good. I can't feel any scoring in the roof in my finger. These valves seem to be open and closing properly. Now they need a cleaning. But that will be just fine. Seeing the lights go out. I'm gonna pull off this coil, clean up. Got 2 5/16 bolts.
using it.
I pinched a little business card in there.
I snugged up the bolts in the head, making sure that the bolts around the exhaust port here are the longest. These three particular bolts are longer than the others. And I'm gonna torque these to 12 foot-pounds in the order that you can see numbered.
Thank you.
out, see if she starts. Some fresh fuel, rebuilt carb, some starter fluid in there, choke is on. Oh yeah. Fires. Hmm.